Hello, this is Lucas Palmeira from Imaginando, and I'm here to give you another episode of Frames from Scratch. On this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make a patch on frames using a paper cola cup. So we're going to do some sounds with a cola cup, and we're going to do a patch. So let's start recording. Okay, guys, now that I've recorded the sounds and cut the samples that we're gonna use, I'm gonna start with a patch. The samples are these ones. And this one. Okay, and this time I'm gonna show you the process. I have nothing prepared, so I'm gonna do it like I normally do when I'm trying to create the sound. So I'm gonna start by loading up the shake, the cola shake, here to the fourth layer. As you can hear now, I'm gonna open up the size, see what we've got. I think I'm gonna increase the gain a little bit. I don't want this to play like this, otherwise it will sound always the same. So I'm gonna go with some modulation here. I'm gonna put a sample and filtered sample and hold. I'm gonna offset it to positive. I'm going to the matrix and I'm gonna automate the offset. So now, let me see. I'll increase the rate at which this changes. It's too much. Okay. And now. Okay, I'm gonna put a little bit of stereo spread, a little bit of reverb. I'm gonna reduce the decay on the reverb and increase the high pass filter. Okay, now I'm gonna go to the second layer and I'm gonna load the other sample, which is the bubbles. I'm going to solo it so I can work on it. I'm gonna get another modifier. Oh, I've got the second one here. Just put the offset at maximum. Matrix and LFO2, I'm gonna offset it as well. Stereo spread on it, increase the window. I want a little bit more density. And amp spread. Now a little bit of reverb, a little bit of delay. And now I'm gonna copy this one to the third layer. I'm gonna change the modifier. I want another one so it doesn't sound like the same. So I'm using 1, 2, let me do 3 as well. Offset to maximum. Decrease the rate a little bit. And now what I want to do is drop an octave on this one. I'm going to increase the size a little bit more. So now I think it's a little bit confused for now, so this is one of them. It sounds nice. A little bit of delay, spread them, get some stereo on the delay, 1/4 triplet, and I'm gonna raise slowly the volume on the second one. So I'm gonna turn it on and raise it like this. It's boiling a lot, so I'm gonna reduce the density a little bit. And now here on the fourth, see how this sounds. Yeah, I prefer this a little bit lower, like this. Just gonna raise the level slowly. I want the time slower, even. Lower the delay. And now for an oscillator. Sustain. Here what I was doing was basically I was trying to get a little bit of saturation on this oscillator, so I decided to go for a square wave and filter it. Okay, so now let's change this envelope generator too. I want it slower. Increase the attack as well. I decided I'm gonna use two oscillators instead of one and take off this second layer to see how it sounds. So I'm gonna copy the first layer and copy it to the second layer. So now I have two oscillators, which I'm gonna detune. Drop the volume a little bit on both. Took too much. I'm gonna give it a little bit of delay. The volume a little bit on frames here so we don't get this a little bit louder. 557, 570. And increase the decay of the reverb just a tiny bit. A little bit more of envelope generator to amount. $310. Thank you. too loud, for sure. I'm gonna drop it to 500. It even clipped, sorry about that. And I'm gonna drop the master to 650, about there. A little bit more, but I think we got there. I think we got it. And this was it, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial, the sound that we made, and all the process in it. If you like our content, please give us a like and subscribe to our channel. That really means a lot to us. I will say goodbye for now and tell you that we will be coming again next week. So, goodbye.